Hello children, welcome for today's biology class. So today we are going to continue the chapter heredity and evolution. So the topics going to be covered are inherited traits and acquired traits, and among evidences of evolution today we are going to cover homologous organs and analogous organs. Okay, now let us go inside the chapter. So you know what is evolution? It is the gradual changes that takes place in living organisms. It gives rise to new organisms, that is due to changes in the genetic composition. So when there is changes in genetic composition, then only new organisms can be originated, formed. Okay, evolution can occur. So the gradual changes, it takes place in the living organism. We studied different type of reasons for speciations, how the speciations it occur. Okay, that and all we studied in the previous part. So today let us see regarding inherited traits and acquired traits. Let us differentiate these two. So inherited traits are the traits in an organism. So that is the change, that is mainly it is the change in genetic composition. The genes, it undergoes changes. So that's why the offsprings of the parents, they may be resembling the parents, not exactly, but there may be some resembling features can be there. So they can inherit the characters from their parents. If it is the genes they are being, you know, they are getting from parents, so they can get the some characters of parents. And even you can show some features of yourself, you know, it may be resembling your grandparents also, because that all are inherited traits. Okay, and next one is acquired traits. So acquired traits are the changes, you know, in the organism. They occur its lifetime. It cannot be passed from one generation to other generation. It is due to environmental change, you know, they produce some changes. So that type of changes, no, it cannot be inherited. So when the change it occurs in genes, then only it can be inherited from one generation to other generation. For example, so your height, maybe height is also determined by environment also, according to the what type of food you take. But anyhow, basically that is by means of genes. And when you observe the hair texture and like that, some of the features, no, is determined by the genes. Acquired traits, sometimes, no, maybe you may be fair, so when you are roaming in sunlight you can become dark, but later when you are sitting in home, once again you may become all right. So there it is acquired trait, because of roaming in sun you have become dark, but later you have become all right because your genetic composition is of fair color. So like that, the inherited trait and acquired trait, I hope you must be able to distinguish between these two. Next one, let us study regarding the evidences of evolution. There are number of features are there in the organism, and by means studying of that features, no, we can find the evolutionary relationship. So what type of that evidences we can get? So that is homologous organ, analogous organs, fossil, embryonic evidence, so many are there. So today let us study regarding homologous organ and analogous organ. This homologous organs are the organs which are similar in structure internally, but when you observe, no, externally they may look different and they may show different functions, but they are similar in structure internally. Okay, but they show different functions. When it is like that, you call that as homologous organ. By studying example, you will understand. You observe, no, the human hand, this is cat's forelimb, this whale's, no, flipper, and bat's wing. All when you observe, no, they show different, no, functions. It is for this is for flying, this is for swimming, this is for walking and running. And human hand, you know, it is, no, very skillful. You can do whatever you want with the help of your human hand. So for various purposes, various, no, functions are there for human hand. It can be for grasping or walking, running, swimming, for various purposes it can, it is used in the case of mammals, the forelimbs are. So, and when you observe, you know, in the case of frog, it is the forelimb for just to raise the front of the body. And birds, when you observe, the forelimbs are modified for flying. Okay, mammals, as I told, for various functions. So why is it like that? But anyhow, when you observe internally, all they will show, no, same type of skeleton system. So for similar skeleton, no, they have given the similar color. The first, the purple color, what they have given, it is humerus bone. And next, radius and ulna, they have been marked by light blue and dark blue color. Okay, here also you can see, here also. And here, then carpal, the wrist bones, no, carpal bones, light yellow color it has been shown here. And in red color, they have shown metacarpals, you can see in all. And phalanges, that is finger bones, can you see here, all it is there. So like that, maybe they are showing different functions, internally they are similar. So that type of organs you call that as what, homologous organs. Here also same thing it has been depicted in this diagram. They show same skeletal structure, but anyhow they show different functions. So why? Because of selection in nature. Because they are flying animals means, so because of that it has been selected here. These all are swimming. They can do, no? They can swim in water. So walk and for various purposes. So like that, according to the selection pressure, they have been shown various adaptations. But anyhow, they show same skeletal structure. These all are homologous organs. Next one, analogous organ. They just opposite. Analogous organs are just opposite to that. The organs, they show different structure, but they have no similar function. Okay, when you observe, all are useful for swimming. Sorry, all are used for flying only. And that all are wings, all are useful for flying, bat wing, bird's wing, insect wing. So all are useful for flying, but looking alike, we call all them as wings. But when you study the internal structure, so here when you observe the bat's wing and bird's wing, they are supported by bones. But when you observe the insect wing, no, they are not at all having bone. Okay, so here it is invertebrate. These two are vertebrate. When you compare insect wing along with either of this or this, then you call that as analogous organ, because it is, no, functionally similar, but when you study the internal structure, no, that is different. Externally, okay, they are, we call that as wing, but internal structure when you study, so that is, no, different. So these all are giving, these are example for analogous organ. So here homologous organ, this entire group, and this is analogous organ. Bat's wing, when it is compared with the butterfly wing, or bird's wing, if it is compared with the butterfly wing, it is coming under analogous organ. These are group of homologous organ, these all are group of analogous organ. Okay, children, hope you must have understand the differences between homologous and analogous organs. Okay, we'll meet in the next class.